Hello, everyone, and welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Coming up, we're joined by Microsoft Security CVP, Rob Lefferts, to give you a first look at the latest updates to help you secure your workplace. Now, we're going to show you Microsoft's approach to protect users, data, endpoints, cloud apps, and infrastructure with Microsoft's end-to-end threat protection. And we're also extending best-in-class protections across platforms with services like Microsoft Defender ATP. And as part of that, we're going to show you how you can actually benefit from cloud-based intelligence with the brand new Threat and Vulnerability Management. Before we get started, everybody, please give me a warm welcome for Rob Lefferts, CVP at Microsoft.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be back.
All right, so last time it was like 2 weeks ago, right?
2 weeks ago, but now I have a jacket.
Yes. We took a look at the family of solutions that really comprise Microsoft Threat Protection, and really how all, through all of this and using the Intelligent Security Graph, we actually pull across the signals, the users for users, data, endpoints, cloud apps, and infrastructure into an incident level set of views in a single dashboard in Microsoft 365. But you guys haven't stopped. You guys continue to innovate in all these different areas. Now, before we dive deep into the big news of the day with Microsoft, Defender ATP and Threat and Vulnerability Management. Can you catch us up on the announcements over the past couple of weeks?
Sure. It's true. We really haven't stopped at all. We're making it easier for you to expand the capabilities of your internal SecOps teams. So we're literally taking threat protection coverage to the next level, expanding the surface area and depth of entities for protection across your Microsoft and broader infrastructure and other clouds. Now, one of the big things we've introduced is the ability to now contact our security experts directly to get help with detecting and understanding security incidents through a new program called Microsoft Threat Experts. Microsoft Threat Experts is a brand new service for critical threat monitoring and hunting, expert analysis, and support from our team of cybersecurity experts. Let's take a look at an example. So this, what I'm showing you, is actually a targeted attack notification. In this scenario, your company has given us permission to hunt across your anonymized and scrubbed information. We've seen something dangerous. In this case, critical active threat related to data staging and exfiltration. So that sounds bad.
Right. Never good.
And we've actually broken it down for you, a timeline of observed events, the list of impacted machines, recommendations, and next steps. And you can get into the details of the full data that we saw, including the alert process tree and the incident graph.
Very cool stuff. So we can actually get the insights from Microsoft experts again to really help you understand the threats in your environment. Now, I also saw in the graphic a second ago that we also had Azure Sentinel, our brand new cloud native SIEM service. Can you explain a bit more what we're doing there?
Yeah, Azure Sentinel is a new cloud native SIEM service with built-in AI for analytics that reduces the cost and complexity of achieving a central and focused near real-time view of the active threats in your environment. Azure Sentinel helps you to collect data at cloud scale across all users, devices, applications, and infrastructure, both on-premises and in multiple clouds. This helps you to detect previously uncovered threats and minimize false positives using analytics and unparalleled threat intelligence. You can also investigate threats with AI and hunt suspicious activities at scale, tapping into decades of work in cybersecurity at Microsoft. And of course, respond to incidents and automate your response workflows. As you see here, for example, approvals to take action, blocking user logins, and even integrating with your infrastructure to block a suspicious IP address. This is all built-in orchestration using the security playbook. And the best part is, there's no security infrastructure to set up and maintain, and it scales elastically with the cloud.
And both Threat Experts as well as Azure Sentinel, they're by design, they're spanning multiple workloads, both cloud services and on-premises infrastructure, right?
That's right. We really have a mission to meet customers where they're at. You shouldn't need to migrate wholesale to the cloud, or conversely, keep everything on-premises to benefit from these capabilities and services. This also applies to your endpoints, where we also want to provide threat protection regardless of the endpoint that you might be using. So today, we're announcing the next phase in broadening support across platforms to additional operating systems, beginning with macOS. What used to be...
You can applaud.
What used to be Windows Defender now runs on a Mac, and of course, it's Microsoft Defender ATP.
All right, now we've built it up. You got to give us a look.
Let's take a look. OK, so I'm on macOS running Mojave. I have, because I'm me, downloaded some dangerous malware from the web.
Never a good thing.
Open it up. yep. and it gets blocked. The virus was detected. I can open up Microsoft Defender ATP, and as I do, I can take actions like quarantining the file. I can see more details on this, and I actually get the familiar Windows Defender, now Microsoft Defender, experience around all of those settings. In addition, it will integrate with our EDR capabilities in the cloud. So all of the signal from this Mac endpoint is coming up here into the Defender Security Center, and I can see, this is the Trojan that ran on that endpoint. I can click into the machine and get the details of the process tree. I can scroll down and see the incident graph. I can scroll even further and look for information about this file in my organization. So I see all of the machines that were impacted. I scroll down and I see, good news, it was just this one machine.
Very cool. So for everybody that's watching, we're actually making the macOS limited preview available today. But what are we doing, in other areas to actually expand endpoint protections?
We're also announcing another capability, and it's called Threat and Vulnerability Management as part of Microsoft Defender ATP. This brings together security operations with our IT admins to discover, and more importantly, address risks, connecting the alerts with their recommended fixes so you can be more effective in quickly responding to threats.
And this is really cool. I think all of this is pretty game-changing stuff, right?
Yeah, this capability is correlating millions of signals across the threat landscape with the information gathered in real time from your endpoints, and then surfaces up your potential risk with rich insights, and lets you take action through integration with our management tools.
And I think to put this into context, and probably everybody here has been there, with an EDR solution, you might get a list of all the impacted devices, then you got to walk over to the IT department for the systems management team and say, here are all the things that I think are affecting our clients. I want to see which clients have those apps installed. They come back with a list. Then you look at this and say, okay, we've got to patch this subset of that list. Maybe a week or so passes, and then finally these systems are up to date.
Yeah, it's very time consuming. As you say, it could take weeks between detecting that you have an issue or vulnerability and getting the systems patched. This is about first addressing potential attacks before they impact you. And second, if something requires immediate action, you can quickly ascertain who is affected and respond faster with everything you need to get the fix deployed.
All right, so again, let's make this real for everyone watching.
Let me show you. We'll start off on the Threat and Vulnerability Management dashboard inside of the Defender ATP console. And the first thing that we see in the upper left is an exposure score. This is telling me about the risk level in my organization, not just about configuration and applications, mm-hmm. but also about what's going on in the threat landscape. And on the right-hand side, it gives me a to-do list. Everything that I should get done in my environment. Now, if you're like me, you may never get to the end of your to-do list, and we want to help you with that problem.
Right.
So today we're going to talk about Contoso Media Player version 3.03, which we see here somewhere down on my list. I should really get on that and make sure that it's patched.
Yep. Well, so what happens? Oh, it looks like you got Twitter open here.
Well, if you're like me, you might follow a bunch of researchers on Twitter in order to stay up to date to news and exciting events.
So it's not always good news, but sometimes 0 days that are there.
Well, what happened in this event, if you're tracking it, you would see, oh no, there's a 0 day inside of Contoso Media Player.
Okay.
Now I realize I've got to do something. The great news is that Threat and Vulnerability Management is on top of that for you. So if we go back to the dashboard, what we actually see is that to-do security recommendation has bubbled up to the top of the list
right.
because Microsoft Defender ATP has detected that for you. We flagged it as a 0 day. We say attention is required. We even suggest alternate mitigations. So if there weren't a patch out yet, it would say, you could disable plugins in
right.
this app, and that would take care of the risk in the interim.
Mm-hmm.
And we give you insights about the threat that has popped up in the environment. So now that vulnerability is being exploited, and Threat Insights tells you about that, and it integrates with threat analytics that we already have in Microsoft Defender ATP,
mm-hmm.
information from our research team telling you what was found, what's going on, now lit up with TVM to give you the list of exposed entities in your organization.
Okay.
Let's go back to the dashboard. And unfortunately, the news just keeps getting worse.
It never gets better on the security side, does it?
Well, so now we actually see that the little target icon has lit up, and there are active alerts in my environment. So there was a 0 day, there was an exploit, and now I am actually actively being attacked.
Right.
And I can click through into that, and because it is part of my EDR system, I'm automatically getting information about, well, what was that alert? How does it fit into a full incident story? Tell me about the details of this device and the individual process tree showing me what happened there.
Yep.
And as I go back, let's start doing something about this.
Let's start figuring out who's impacted.
Here we see in the list of top vulnerable software, we're actually building an inventory of all the apps in your environment. And we collect that in near real time, noticing not only what is installed, but also what is being used and how are users applying it. As we click into Contoso Media Player, we get the full rundown. Here's all the security recommendations. Here's all the discovered vulnerabilities and published CVEs. Mm-hmm. Here's the list of exposed devices that are impacted.
Right.
I can check one out. Let's click on that machine.
It's getting more red.
There's more red on the screen. What's interesting is that we look at the device, we actually see that information about what kind of data is on that device and the fact that it's a high-value asset. So we're actually pulling the sensitivity labels from information protection on the laptop to show there's confidential information
on this device. So this is a pretty bad laptop to be exposed.
Getting hacked. I think we should get ahead of this.
Right.
I think we should do something about it.
Okay.
Let's go back to the dashboard. Let's click on Update Contoso Media Player.
Okay.
This actually prepares everything that you need in order to package up the fix and start to get it deployed. In many large organizations, this is a tag team event between the security team and the IT team. Can
right.
you play the IT team for
I
me?
I will, yes. This
Excellent.
Is an easy job for me as the IT team, so go for it.
So I can check on this update using analytics to actually see how broadly is it deployed on the planet, is it reliable and usable, and then I can request immediate remediation, which points to the update, gives a full list of the impacted machines, creates a machine group for that, and hands it over into a security task
force. So basically, I've got a device group, a collection of devices that I need to actually push this patch to. I've already got the package in my environment, so I can just basically target those machines, get that out. And the nice thing is, Rob doesn't even have to call me later, because now when we go back into the console, you can monitor it, right?
Yeah. Not that I don't trust you, but it's great to be able to stay up to date. And so the Microsoft Defender ATP sensor is telling me, as those patches roll out, how do machines get updated. I can validate that everything is getting to a good and healthy state. Mm-hmm. And once that's done, we actually see the exposure score come back to its normal place.
Very cool. Everything's back to normal. What I really like about this is you kind of expect monitoring, maybe some light remediation from other EDR tools and solutions. But because we've got all of this client policy configuration, software update management capability, we go way beyond kind of the simple fixing.
That's right. We want to be the best and most complete endpoint protection for organizations of all sizes.
It's a really great set of updates today. You heard it here and saw it here first. Now, if you want to start trying some of these capabilities out for yourself, where do you recommend that people go to get started?
Sign up for the previews and get the necessary trials running. Azure Sentinel preview is out. Give it a run. Microsoft Defender ATP on macOS, if you have, and also, if you haven't tried it on Windows, you should try that too. And try out Threat and Vulnerability Management, coming to preview next month in Microsoft Defender ATP.
And of course, you wouldn't be Rob Lefferts without your token recommendation.
Yeah, since I'm a security professional, let me offer some tips. Actually, I'll offer the same tip I had last time, because I know it's still such a big issue for organizations. If you haven't turned on multi-factor authentication, please make sure that you do that and start on your journey towards passwordless authentication.
Thanks, Rob. And of course, we're going to keep following and tracking the latest security updates at Microsoft. So thanks for watching at Microsoft Mechanics today. Hit subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time. Goodbye for now.